You've not enough minerals. You're playing against early CCs. All spawn. I think even if I go Zealot, I mean, I guess Zealot's probably fine. All spawn still. Kinda crappy, like not as good as it could be, but still fine. Part of the problem though is I don't know the exact build when you go Zealot, because I never actually watched someone do it, so I don't know what the timing of stuff is, like when I'm supposed to gas and everything. Maybe I just don't core right away. Sell it before core. Like the only Protoss on the planet, gonna complain about a cross spawn. It'd be better if I just run into the main with the Zealot, but I don't, I like really wanted to stall the PC. Sure. That was bad. I'll start my citadel. Thank you.
foundational pylons.
Where else to go with this thing? It's time to die. I said it'll still didn't start, by the way. Holy. That's amazing. You can tell I don't play Reaver often. Pretty ugly. Still should be in the lead, but the supply blocks and forgetting tech is pretty bad. He's bad too. Pro count feels good. He's on 3 base, we're on 4. Should be taking a 5th by now. Fly's looking fine. Got our storm. It's our gateway count. Maybe a little too zealot heavy. Actually, definitely too zealot heavy. Alright, so we're maxed, but get this third on this. I got the other storm off. I think he's on 4 base. No? Okay. our pro count's fun. I just needed the one warm-up game. I feel like I'm playing fine now. Hi, Ice. Sorry, I just saw your message when this game ended. Like, literally just tabbed out and started responding. Yeah, we can hang out. So let me look at this real quick. Yeah, sorry about that. Playing against, Hawk. He is off-racing, but I'm a big fan of Hawk, so it's cool to get to play against him, even off-racing. Put 4 on gas, but I fixed it kind of quick. I kind of wanted to see the game state after the opener here. I feel like going Zealot here helped me so much that I wasn't super far behind. Even though I kind of got pulled around, it delayed his CC for a long time. He had two workers off and he made a bunch of extra marines. So the one Zealot I feel like did pay for itself. Because it also led to his factory getting delayed a lot. So, CC timing versus Nexus, I am still behind for sure. We're up one worker. So I think we'll come out pretty close to even, maybe even slightly ahead, because you won't be mining with these. It might have been better if I just ran into the main with my Zealot, like I was saying, but I feel like delaying the CC was more important. And then another big thing was getting this tank. So we're actually up a couple workers. It's not great to only be up two workers, but he wasn't mining with four the entire time. It's not too bad. And then our Reaver got in here. This is where I think we turned it into more of a lead. Look at our worker production behind those two. So we're doing good with the workers behind it, but multitasking is not great. I don't play Reaver too often. If I'd been paying attention, I could have picked up a tank there. Got a Reaver shot and almost finished it. So we got a third up in mining, and we're like way up on SCVs or workers now. So the Reaver got us... Like, we were kind of even. I was maybe slightly behind still after the beginning. But the Reaver got us ahead. I did suicide these two Reavers. This did not pay for itself. I knew I shouldn't have even gone for it, but I feel like I needed to do something with my Reaver. So this was really wasteful. Just having that for the bust would have been really good. I need to not feel pressure like that. Do something with it. It had already kind of done its job. And I knew turrets would be up. Or at least when I saw these turrets, I should have turned around. Like, I guess checking for turrets is totally fine, but I shouldn't have committed after I saw. Let's see what my worker count ends up at. Yeah, I kind of felt like I had overmade workers. I'd probably go over 80. This guy randomly recommended I'm not a fan of StarCraft, so I'm not going to stick around, but have a fantastic stream and rest of your day. I appreciate that, man. Thanks for poking in, even though you don't play the game. I don't know why YouTube does that. I think this bust went okay. If I got the two storms off, it would have been great, but we still cleaned up a lot of tanks. Maybe overstayed a little bit, let off like three or four more goons, but I think staying up to that point was fine, because we cleared a lot of tanks. You have a good day too, man. I appreciate you. Dude, that's what I was just saying that yesterday. I was like, I never see Hawk playing Zerg. Yet when he does play Zerg, it doesn't look like he hasn't been practicing. Dude looks in shape no matter what. So at this point, 83 workers is a little too heavy on workers. Maybe should have even sacked a couple. Yeah, he took a lot of damage in the beginning of the game. I ended up at like almost 60 workers when he was at 38 or something like that. It's actually one of the reasons I actually fought him head on, was because of the upgrades. I better win this. This is one of those rare moments where even though he had a pretty good supply and a really high tank count, I feel like fighting him head-on is fine. We denied his fourth base here, and his upgrades were 1-1, so I feel like I can fight pretty well. I'm actually ahead on upgrades right now. And my eco's pretty huge at 83 workers, 5 base. And then one more storm there. There's another one up there, too. I was pretty much never uncomfortable at this point. Like, I knew my macro was pretty huge right now. Yeah, 83 is a little high. I'd like to have gone maybe 75 in this situation. That's all good. As long as I'm fighting non-stop, it's fine.